Lord, come on.
Thank you. You know, I was honored to be sitting next, and I didn't realize that someone brought it up to Dr. Clarence Law's son. And we were sitting, he was one of the leaders of the NAACP way back when times were troubling. And we sit and talk. He said, yeah, Dad used to take me on some of those marches too. He said, but I was scared. I said, so was he. He said, well, he didn't act like it. I said, that's the whole idea. Because there I am, and I'm thinking about the world championship, and I'm fighting Joe Frazier. And my Archie Moore had told me, you look him in the eye, and don't you take your eyes off him, and make him drop his head. And I was thinking, we're in the middle of the ring smoking Joe Frazier. I said, I sure hope he doesn't drop his head because he's going to see my knees shaking. So you do this dance like, oh yeah, just to hide your knees. So I was afraid. All the time I was afraid. And I said, I can't keep living like this, being scared when I get into the ring. So I got to Africa, Zaire, for the first time after all of those fights, maybe 40 boxing matches, I wasn't afraid. I got into the ring. Next thing I know, I was listening to one, two, three. And I could hear him on the other side. I told you I was the greatest. So the one thing we all need, and I'm certain we all need, is fear. And I'm not going to acknowledge my wife tonight because she's the one who wrote that check you just saw. And you always hear those stories about, why is that old man going back to boxing? I got to go back to boxing. But there was one gentleman here today, it was 1965, on the buddy plan. I never would have left Houston, Texas. And I was discussing my being inducted into the Hall of Fame, and I said, can you believe that we're on this airplane leaving out of Houston to get a job? He said, oh, we were trying to get out of trouble. And that's all my best friend, Roy Harrison, there. He's there to enjoy this night with me. Thank you. Roy, stand up for a second. And if we hadn't taken that trip, we surely would have been there in the Hall of Fame for mugging people. And I'll leave it on the note because everybody's always asking me about Muhammad Ali. We never met in Africa, and you'll never see photographs of us together, so we didn't speak. First time I met him in the ring, we had a little conversation. He said, George, you were just a little kid in high school when I was beating Sonny Liston, trying to psych me out. And I laughed. I said, man, I never spent one day in high school. The conversation continued. He said, George, show me something. I said, okay. I started to show him a few things. Then afterwards, he said, that all you got, George? I remember saying, yes. And the next thing I know, Zach Clayton, the referee, interrupted the whole conversation by counting one. Anyway, I'm so happy to be with you, and I thank God for this honor. Thank God for this room and all of the friends and neighbors and family. My cousin last year, Charles Green, he showed me the way here, and we have that Moorhead connection, so I want to thank God for that. My real cousin beat me to the Hall of Fame. Can you believe that? So, and thank you, and God bless.